In this video, I want to talk about processing your orders. And you'll notice here on my to-do list, I have two notifications. Once your orders start flowing into your store, you'll see the most recent orders that may need attention. Well, to take a look at my sales, I hover over my sales and I click on orders. Now I have three orders here, one that's paid and awaiting processing, one that's awaiting payment and awaiting processing, and one that's paid and shipped. If I click on the paid dropdown here, you'll notice I have a number of different options. A product can be paid for, awaiting payment, canceled. As an administrator, I can cancel an order if payment hasn't been made in a decent amount of time. I can also refund or even partially refund an order if there are multiple items in an order that need to be refunded. On the processing dropdown, I have awaiting processing, processing, ready for pickup, shipped, delivered, will not deliver, and returned. On any given order, I can update the status of processing whenever I need to. Well, the first thing we need to talk about is keeping track of the orders. When a new order comes in, you'll get an alert. That'll either be an email, or if you're using one of our fantastic mobile apps and have notifications turned on, well, you'll get a notification. And actually, I can't encourage you enough to consider one of the mobile apps. They are really well written and a great way to manage your store. All of the orders for my store are listed here on the order screen, and the most recent ones are here at the top. If I click on filter, I can filter my orders by date, payment status, fulfillment status, payment method, shipping method, pickup date and time, and products. You can even search by order number, customer details, and items ordered. Now this is incredibly helpful if you have a really busy store and need to look at orders in any filtered way. I only have three, so it's not quite that necessary. And you'll note that at the top here, I have a status message that tells me what orders I'm currently viewing. That's really helpful. The next step in any order processing is making sure you got paid, and then of course, shipping the item. This one has been paid and it's awaiting processing. So let's take a look at this one first. I can print the invoice. I can see all of the details. I know that they wanted it shipped USPS priority mail one day, and they paid by cash. When I'm ready to update the order, there are multiple ways to do that. Even from this screen, I can view the order, update the status, mark as shipped, edit the order, and print invoice. You'll need a business or unlimited plan in order to actually edit an order. Well, let's take a look. Clicking on the arrow takes me to all of the details for this particular order. I can print the invoice, I can again update the order from this handy dropdown, and I can change the payment and fulfillment status from these dropdowns if necessary. When it's ready, the purchaser wants me to ship it USPS priority mail one day, and depending on the shipping service you're using, you can even add a tracking number when the order has shipped. I can see how they paid, what they paid, and some other miscellaneous information. When you're looking at a product, if the product has options, they'll be listed here for you to see. Well, let's say that because this person ordered a monogram, I need to let them know that the order's in process. I just need to go ahead and change that to processing, and the customer will receive an email as long as you haven't disabled email notifications here under settings and mail. When the processing is finished, again, I just come back into the order and I can say shipped. The customer will receive an email, again, assuming you've left those enabled. And if I've put a tracking number here, they'll get that tracking number in their email. You'll note that there's no save button on this screen. In the orders section here, every time I make a change, the changes are saved automatically, except for when I add a note. There's one last piece to order processing I want to highlight. If I click and select one or more orders, you'll notice that there are some mass update options. I can print them all, export them to a spreadsheet, change the payment status for any selected order, change the fulfillment status for any selected order, and I can even delete selected orders. Now, I'd suggest you want to be careful with that. It's probably a good idea to keep your order history, whether it was fulfilled or not, so you'll understand how your store is being used. But this mass update option is really terrific, and can save you a ton of time. When it comes to shipping out your orders, there's a lot of different options with Ecwid. You might have noticed in a previous video, we set up USPS. If I come down here and click on Apps and App Market, and click on Catalog and Order Management, you'll notice there's a number of terrific add-ons for your Ecwid store. These apps do have additional paid services, but most of them offer free trial periods, so you can make sure it's the option you want to use. And that's how to process your orders with Ecwid.